Manhattan, fast food, Dakar, Sénégal, la grand-mère à l'hôpital, Dantec, tout va bien, Kairé, moi ici, toi là-bas, le visa au consulat, numéro 39, y attend, à l'état civil, déjà l'an 2000, déjà 2000 ans, au Manhattan, fast food, Dakar, Sénégal, cinéma, le Paris.
Hello, welcome to Aarti Paarti Season 3! We're back! What? And we're starting it with a bang. We're going to go watch the Muppet movie outside. It's going to be so much fun, and so we're having a picnic. And I am making some picnic peanut pasta with pickled cucumbers. I have one of those big old English cucumbers. You can use whatever you want. And I just bought this cheapy Japanese mandolin. It was like $2 or something. You can slice it yourself, but I don't think I can slice as finely as a sweet gem can. See, it gives you these lovely, like, paper thin. You can even see me through them. Kinda, maybe. Just a little bit of sugar, which I know sounds really funky, but it's really good. It's just the tiniest little bit. A little bit of salt. And then some rice wine vinegar. I'm just eyeballing it. Can't really go wrong. Yum! Yeah, okay. And then taste it. It's like salty and sweet and a little bit of vinegar. And then we're gonna put it in the fridge and let it sit while we make the rest of it. It's gonna cook, kind of pickle down a little bit. Yum! So last night I got a couple of chicken breasts and I marinated them in some sesame oil and some soy sauce and some ginger and some garlic. That's it. This is for that lady that keeps writing to me and saying not to use nonstick. I've got my cast iron skillet out, so I hope you're happy. My favorite thing about these peanut noodles is actually every now and then, believe it or not, I get hungover. And it's great hangover food because it's like kind of stodgy and kind of greasy, but you put all these vegetables in it, it makes you feel so much better. So put this one in your banks, people, because I know you guys suffer from hangovers. That's my audience, the hangover audience. So it has so many things that I had to write it down in a book, so I'm gonna be consulting my book. Alright, so let's go.
Moving right along. Footloose and fancy free.
Getting there is half the fun. Come share it with me.
Moving right along.
We'll learn to share the load.
We don't need a map to keep this show on the road.
Hey, the song is sounding better, Fozzie.
Okay, and then last but not least, you'll need a cup of strong black tea. Not your Earl Grey or anything. I'm using just some plain old Indian black tea. And make sure it's piping hot, because it'll help everything dissolve. So let it go for a few minutes, you know, really try to pulverize those sesame seeds and get it really nice and smooth. Time to taste. Ready? It's like pow, pow. It's so good. The cool thing too is if you're cooking for children, I mean, of course they're gonna love this, right? But you can use whole grain pasta. Since my husband is kind of like a grown child, he doesn't like whole grain pasta, but with the peanut sauce, you can't even tell the difference. So it's great. Sorry, babe. Exactly.
You're a child.
You're a child. Now, I did pound them. I used a big old meat mallet and I pounded the heck out of them so they were all even, just so they would cook quicker. Because I don't want to be late for the movie. Once you put it in your skillet, leave it alone. Don't move it around, don't shake your pan, don't, you know, just leave it. It's the most boring thing. If you move it before it's done and browned and everything, then it's going to rip and tear and all that kind of stuff. When it's properly browned on that side, it's going to turn over super simply. While our chicken is cooking, I'm going to get going with our vegetables. So with the asparagus, I'm going to put it in raw. So I'm just going to cut the tips off, these pretty little heads, like that. And then just cut them on a diagonal.
Why?
They look prettier. Come on, look how pretty that is. Isn't it gorgeous? Hello? He doesn't think it's that gorgeous. And then I have my red pepper that I've already done. I just take a paring knife and slice it really thin. Drizzle a little bit of sesame oil over them so that they're less clumpy. I toss the vegetables with a little bit of the sauce. Sometimes when I've had it, the vegetables don't have any sauce on them. What's the point of that, I ask you? They absorb a lot of sauce. I have my leftover sesame seeds. It just looks so good. And then let's put our vegetables in. Just a little bit of lime juice to freshen it up. Okay, time for a test. Whoa. I guess it's gonna be an unladylike big mouthful. Oh well. I'm so excited. I'm really happy. Because I wanted to serve something good to all my friends at the Muppets movie. Okay, I'm gonna put this in the fridge so it chills before we go.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions.
So this is peanut noodles, and there's like some asparagus and some red bell peppers in it, very fancy.
I was told there would be thousands of people here, including some live ones.
Someday we'll find it.